Hello everyone and welcome back to ZooCrafting! I am Zookeeper Siri and we are here for season 4 of ZooCrafting! And this time we're not in the zoo, we are still camping. Which shouldn't come as a big surprise because we have a huge camping project to work on this month. And that is going to be... dun 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 dun! Continuing work, or I really should at this point say beginning work, on our Red Wolf National Forest! I'm so excited! Okay, but we haven't really made any progress on the Red Wolf National Forest. Not my fault. I had to take care of a grave yesterday. You can hardly expect someone to expect graves just popping up on cliff sides. Chicken, are you okay? You better not be in a grave too. Oh, those butterflies! Look at those butterflies! Look, there's a moth! There's a moth down on the ivy! Oh my gosh! Oh, there's something! Oh, there's just butterflies and leaves everywhere. I am so excited. I have my butterfly net. I am ready to catch these puppies. This would be so exciting. I need a way to get down to that little valley a lot faster. Right now I just sort of tumble down a cliffside, quite painful, not highly recommended. And we also need to make a path so that we can go and explore that academy. So that is definitely something we need to work on too. There's more butterflies. Oh my gosh. We definitely need to have a butterfly, like a little butterfly house. I think I will actually surround the top of the little balcony that you can see over there on the academy. And we're going to turn that academy into a ranger station, which will be awesome enough. But I think I will actually turn the top of it into a butterfly house because there's so many butterflies here. I think any of the others who want to come over to the spot on the server and be able to like collect up butterflies and build their butterfly books, because there's these really cool books that you can fill out, your butterfly encyclopedia, this would be a good spot to come do that because they definitely seem to spawn quite often here. So let me see. I forget how many butterfly species there are, but there's over 200, as you can tell from the listing of specimen 200. Unknown appearance. It appears on dead bushes, grass blocks, red sand, tall grass. That tells me I would probably be able to find it possibly in a desert. So that would be really interesting to see. But yeah, there's hundreds of specimens of butterflies to catch. So it would be really fun to just bring everybody here and have like a really fun butterfly catching day. All right. So that said, what to work on today? I think we're going to, now that I have a teensy bit of food with the spring onions of friendship soup and the garden soup, work on making paths and getting over to the academy. And then after we get that done so that we can have a clear path through the woods, because although it is a national forest, we do want to make sure, come along Lillian Tate, we do want to make it so that there's like dirt paths going through the woods and it's fairly easy to walk around. So it's not going to be untamed wilderness. We're going to be taming it, just taming it carefully, like very cautiously taming it, but it's not going to look like that where it's just this endless wave of trees. We are going to have paths going through. We'll have little informational stations. We'll set up more tents. That would be really, really fun. Maybe some cabins that people could stay at when they want to come and visit. Like, wouldn't that be a fun spot to put a cabin right on top of that little floating, is that a floating island? Oh my gosh. Well, maybe not on top of a floating island. Look at all the butterflies. There's so many butterflies. That's amazing. Or maybe, what about on top of there? Wouldn't it be amazing to have some sort of like outlook that we could build up there that people could climb up to and they could just look on top of the outlook at all of this beautiful stuff? We could even have a chocobo landing station up there. That would be so cool too. That's also where the apple tree is. I need to go and harvest that apple so I can make more apple trees all over the place. Oh gosh. But yes. So that is why we are cutting down the trees, because I know a few people have been laughing. They're like, Siri, you say you're going to take care of the forest and then you come and you cut down the trees. Well, we're clearing the trees out right now and it's a bit of a pity, but we're doing it because this is going to be a manicured area, meaning we do need to make it so people can safely walk on a bunch of paths up and down the hillside. I'm just gonna have to start taking some of these out, aren't I? Up and down the hillside. So I'm going, oh, there's the bluebird. I'm going to need to, oh no, I fell down. Get up the cliffside, get up the cliffside. I'm gonna need to make some carpenter's blocks so that I can make it really easy for us to zoom up and down the side of the cliff. So let me grab some, where's my shovel? I know I have my shovel in here somewhere. And maybe this is too powerful of a shovel, actually. This is my good diamond shovel with efficiency 4 and fortune 2. But we do need to make it so people can walk around. So yeah, not pure wilderness, you guys. We are talking about like campsites. We're talking about some kiosks here and there that will give people information about the forest. We're talking about cultivating the wilderness just a tad. If you want straight up wilderness, you can just walk that way and have whatever that forest is to explore. But this is supposed to be like an educational area, and it is supposed to be like a wildlife reserve, sort of like a national park wildlife reserve where you could learn from. So think more like a North American forest safari zone. Does that make sense? Where there's going to be trails and tracks, and it's going to be kind of sculpted and kind of manicured, not totally wild, but the animals are going to be roaming versus in exhibits like at our zoo. And speaking of roaming animals, we do need to make our way over to the academy so I can make a pig pen and a cow pen over there, and eventually we'll move all of the pigs and cows to other locations. And there's another squirrel! Oh my gosh, they're so cute. I love seeing the squirrels running around. Okay, enough rambling. I'm just so excited. All right, and we're gonna start clearing away some of this path, and I'm gonna have to figure out how we can make it so we can just go straight up and down. Oh my gosh, this is gonna be a little bit tricky. Yeah, figuring out how to get up and down from the cliffside is going to be my first task as a ranger to this forest, and that may be a little harder than it looks. So let's clear out some more of these trees. Hello, cow. But at least we have a good spot to angle ourselves towards, because we just want to work towards getting to the academy. So let's clear out trees and let's see what it would take to make our way. Lily, do be careful. That's not fair, puppies. I shouldn't have to worry about dogs falling out of trees. You're not like birds. You're not a bird, Lily. I love you, but you're not. That's your like niece, Holly. But we'll talk about that in a dog quest episode in the future. Cough, cough. All right. So I do want to be able to get up and down pretty quickly. So where was the spot? Was it over here, Tate? Yeah, it was over here that I made it. So I am going to have to come over and work on this dirt a little bit so we have a path to get up and down, but at least there's a vague path. We can start here, and I'll have to come over, and what I'll do is I will make some carpenter's blocks that will be nice slopes. What are you? Come back here. Come back here, beautiful black butterfly. I can't claw my way up the... I caught it! Oh, it's a peacock butterfly. Oh gosh, I have so many of those. I may let that one go then, because I have a lot of peacock butterflies. That's kind of hilarious that I was so excited. It was different color from underneath. Normally I see them from up top, and they are different colors from underneath. And I think I will plant a few more of the oak trees. I'll put them down to make up for all the oak trees I'm cutting down. But it is good to have some oak wood so that we can start making some of the light sources, and we can start making some of the... so we can start making some of the benches and other stuff. Good. So there's a clear path to walking up to my little campsite. Lily, I could probably come over here and put some oak trees along the side of the cliff if they want to grow here. That would be great. If they decide no way, we can remove the saplings in the future. There we go. But that'll help out. All right, look at that, you guys. Oh, and I still need to work on getting some shears so that I can gather up leaves. All right, so little path. Little path, that's a fine first goal, I suppose. It's been a long time. I mean, this is basically pure wilderness, and you just start by clearing spots out. Lily, do be careful! You can't fly, Lily! I know you want to, but you can't, my dear. All right, so there we go. Now we have a path back up to our house, which is important. And it's getting dark already. Oh, phooey. Well, you know what? I'm going to keep my gear on, and then we can at least put our torches down, and I can replace the torches as needed, because I want to get some work done today. So, continuing through the... Oh, I'm so sorry, cow! Jeez, what? I shouldn't have cows and dogs, like, jumping out of trees at me. That's not fair. I understand the birds and the squirrels, but having bovines leaping from trees, I shouldn't have to expect that. This is a very interesting, there's cows. There's like cow fruit. Is that what I'm going to call this? Is there cow fruit? Oh gosh, now I want to work on making cool hybrid plants that actually would be like little cow berries. That would be so adorable. But we'll worry about that later. All right, let's clear this out of the way to you. All right, there we go. That took care of this. Rubber tree, actually. So, come on, buddy. Oh, he's almost ready to go. I just need to get a little higher. Where's my little dirt block? Darn. I don't have any dirt blocks on me. Oh. Oh, since when did I have some sort of mod installed where the light torch moves with me? I don't remember doing that, but I'm not going to complain. I definitely need to... I guess I have a shader or something in. Hey, look at me, guys! Wherever I walk, it's like I'm wearing a light ring in Stardew Valley, and so the light comes with me. That's really cool. All right, well, let's continue clearing away these trees, even though they do appear to have a bunch of cowberries, having grown to being full-size cows. The cowberry is a very marvelous creature. Half plant, half creature, possibly a cousin of the cow plant. All right, let's see. Let's go ahead and jump over here. And there we go. Oh, the night is so pretty. Oh, this is gorgeous. Also, I'm remembering how hard it is to actually cultivate wilderness. We've hardly moved from our base camp, and I've hardly made any progress towards the academy. But this is how hard it is to just like dive into the wilderness and start clearing out trees and making progress. All right, we're clear of cowberries. So many cow fruit, cowberries. Oh dear, there's a little nest. Oh no, we have disturbed a little nest, you guys. With an ostrich egg inside. Okay, that's normal. Alrighty then. And darn, the nest fell apart. Alright, so yeah, there was an ostrich egg inside of that nest. That's not what I expected to find up in a tree. But I will accept that. We can work with that in the future. All right, let's go ahead and clear some of these out. Lots of apples. I think I can actually use these apples. And if I combine them with oak saplings, we can make apple saplings. Let's grab a couple. Wherever the apples fall from trees, I'll go ahead and put some apple saplings down, like over here. And don't eat it, Cal. Those are supposed to grow into, well, that one's probably a little too close to the other one. But these are supposed to grow into big, beautiful apple trees that the animals can enjoy. I actually saw a squirrel the other day in my neighborhood who had an entire pear, it was a peach. He had an entire peach in his mouth, and I have no idea where he got an entire peach because it's winter, and there's definitely no peach trees where we live, so I have no idea how he got his paws on an entire peach, but he was sitting on, oh wow, look at that. Wow, it's dark moon. I totally forgot how there would be different colors. Oh, that's beautiful. But yeah, the squirrel was sitting on top of a power line eating a peach, and I thought it was quite interesting. And when I walked up to get a better look, he dropped his peach, and he had a lot to say to me about daring to get too close while he was eating peaches. Oh, it's so thick with trees here. Oh, hi, boar. Please don't attack me. But it's so thick with trees here, you can hardly see, but this is very pretty. Oh, I think people will really enjoy coming to camp here. I think this is going to be really nice. All right, I'm going to leave a trail of torches behind me. That'll actually really help when it comes to figuring out where to place the pathing in the future. And I'm going to go ahead and clear away this tree, that birchwood tree. I'm getting a lot of saplings, which is probably a good thing. Here's another apple. So I'll go ahead and make another apple tree just real fast. I think it's a nice idea to just constantly be putting apple trees down wherever I happen to come across an apple that falls from an oak tree. All right, and we're gonna go ahead and hope that that boar decides not to attack me. I always hate when they attack me because then I have to attack them back. Oh, wow, look at this, you guys. Oh, wow. Does this continue? Oh my goodness, it continues. I wonder if this goes over to the ravine. Look, you can see fossils down there. Oh, this is beautiful. Oh, geez, bunny. There's a bunny. There's a ravine bunny. There's just a wild bunny diving into the caves. I'm going to name it Bones. We're going to name the bunny, and then we're going to release the bunny. It's on my head. There we go. Now it's off my head because we found this bunny while we were looking at fossils. And the mole appears to be in a territory battle with this bunny. It does not want us in its territory. But we're gonna leave the bunny here. And it's going to be a wild bunny, but we'll have nicknamed it Bones because of where we found it. Hi, Bones. And, oh, look at the beautiful, beautiful stones. There's fossils. We'll have to come and collect those later. And there's another little path down here. It leads over to lava. I need to be very careful. Lily enjoys swimming in lava too much. There's actually a fire. Whoa, this is pretty. What? The vines are on fire. What? Lily, no, Lily. Why? Why does she love swimming in lava so much? Lily, Lily, Lily. Lily! Lily, get in the water! Oh, Tate, sit! No, sit! Don't eat the food! Sit! Don't eat the food out of my hand! Lily, get in the water! Oh my gosh, Lily! Oh, I love you. Why are you? No, Lily, get out of there! Lily, stop! Oh my gosh, do I have a bucket? Do I have a bucket to start putting some of this out? I don't think I do. Oh my goodness. Oh, Lily, why? Okay, let's see. Can I open my backpacks? Why won't my backpacks open? That is so weird. Okay, deep breath. Oh my, that was a little exciting. Sorry about that, you guys. I had a sudden lag spike and I couldn't move and I was drifting towards the lava. And so I was getting pretty agitated because I had fallen in the water and I was drifting to the lava, and that would have been really bad news bears. The fire is still, it's still right here because it's clinging to the vines, but I think I put it out and I managed to get Lily. She's still on fire. So let's come over to the water. All right, come on, Lily, you know better. Why is it every time we run into lava, she absolutely has to jump in it? I don't understand that. I just don't. Lily, okay, you eat some more duck and sweet potatoes so you feel better, but don't go in the lava again, you silly goose. You may be an immortal dog, but that doesn't mean I enjoy watching you like burn to a crisp, okay? All right, come on, Tate. And this was a pretty spot at least, so we managed to do a little exploring. There's a little chicken. Wow, and it is very pretty over here. This is so funny, the way that the fire is just, it's caught on the vines here. There we go, and at least we stopped the vines from burning down. And there's some really beautiful, I think these are actually, no, that's fluorite ore. There's another crystal that looks a lot like this that's actually the maple diamonds. So that would be fun. We'll have to go mining sometime soon. I love going mining. All right, and we definitely did explore this area a teensy bit too. Wonderful, and we found a bunny named Bones. Oh my gosh, it keeps going on over here too. We haven't even made it to the academy yet, and look at all of this. Look at all of this. There's so much zebra ore. That would be so fun to gather. Okay, we'll have a good time. We'll have a good time going mining here. I think the mining will be fun. We will probably allow mining in the National Forest simply because it's the above ground stuff that we're more focused on for education. So I think mining would be okay. That'd be kind of fun. All right, so what's this? Okay, this is a little cave system yet again. Is this going to lead me towards... Here's my last torch. All right, I think I came this direction. I'm gonna put a torch right here. Okay, nope, I popped right over here. So let me pick that up. I'm leaving the torches behind me so I know where to make my path. And we're gonna continue on in this direction, hoping that I can eventually reach the academy today. So the path to the academy has already gotten a lot more interesting than I thought it would be. And we're gonna continue. Oh, there it is! You guys, the beauty of the academy right there. Oh, that's so exciting to find. I popped out right next to it when I was over here. All right, let's go ahead and get this up. And I'm gonna put away a whole bunch of the wood and everything we've been collecting. There we go, especially the mushrooms and an ostrich egg. Oh my gosh, we'll have to see if it hatches into an ostrich later. That'll be really cool. All right, a whole bunch. Artist conchs and turkey tails. I love the appetite mushrooms. We'll put the little peacock away. Peacock in a jar, being the peacock being the butterfly and not an actual peacock, though we do have actual peacocks in this world too. All right, and we're almost to the academy. So, oh, look at the birds. Jeez, I love the wilderness in our world. It is just so amazing. Amazing. Oh my gosh, Siri. All right, so where are we? Oh, perfect! There's a big field right over here already. That would be perfect for putting all of the cows. There's a few cows here. Yes, cows! Yes, you, my bovine friend! So I can make some fencing and I can start bringing... I thought I heard something hiss at me. And I can start bringing the cows over here and we can gather up all of the stray cows and pigs and we can give them a little bit of territory to relax in. Because you guys don't belong in the wild, my friends. And it looks like the academy comes half in the water. So this is gonna be interesting. Let's go ahead and swim over. This is so fun. Oh, this is just really feeling like the first season of Zoo Crafting. And there's a baby deer. There's a baby deer right over there. It feels like the first season all over again when we would find like the village of fish sandwiches and we would make so many discoveries in these areas. Do you guys remember? Oh, my heart. I remember. Oh, this is so cool. There's even ducks. There's even ducks. There's wild ducks here. This is the best. Maybe we can bring some of our wild ducks, the ducks that we have in the zoo that we've been breeding up, and we can release them in the national park here. This would be so amazing. Okay, so how do I get in? I didn't see an entrance on the other side, so let's run on this side. Oh, look, there's deer. There's deer and a raccoon. There's a raccoon raiding a nest here. And there's another deer right there. Oh my gosh. Okay, and what's inside here? A penguin egg. Okay, I'm going to snag the penguin egg, but I will leave the eggshells. It looks like the raccoon got to it before we did. Is that a wild lyrebird? That's a wild lyrebird. That's a wild lyrebird. Lily. Oh my gosh. I got it. We used to have a lyrebird and we lost it. It will mimic the sounds of all Minecraft mobs. I am so excited. Jin, Lily, that's going to be so exciting to have a lyrebird that we can listen to and it'll make all sorts of interesting sounds. There's another one. I wonder if that was their nest. And so, oh my gosh, I've never seen wild lyrebirds before. This is so cool. And they do mimic the sounds of Minecraft mobs. So you may hear like hissing, growling, zombies. You may hear cows during the daytime. The exotic birds, lyrebirds, which is made from one of our zoo crafting members, Pavo, who does really awesome zoo crafting episodes, by the way. But during the daytime, the lyrebirds will actually mimic passive mobs, and at night, they will mimic dangerous mobs, which is just, oh, that's so cool. I'm so excited that we have some lyrebirds. And there's more cowberries. Oh my gosh, so many cowberries. And we have made it, finally, to the academy. So if the cow can manage to figure out how to get up on top of the academy, I'm pretty sure I can too. So we should be able to... did that do it? Nope. All right. Oh, the door is right here. The door is literally right here. All right. And here we are, you guys. The interior of the academy. Oh, and Lily and Tate are walking on the pressure plate. So hopefully nothing will blow up. But this looks really fun. So we're going to come in and we're going to start filling in some of the gaps. And we are going to start renovating this place. And we can use it as a resource deposit. And eventually we will actually turn the entire academy into a really beautiful and hopefully a really nice ranger station for our national forest. So people can come in and they can do a little bit of shopping for different camping gear they may need. They can read up about the rules of the area. They can see interesting specimens. They can learn about the different animals that are going to live here. Lily is scaring me because she's taking off after something and that cow is slowly working its way in. Oh, this is awesome. So next time we're going to go ahead and start exploring this place and we will see what the academy has to offer and start coming up with ways that we are going to transform this academy from a deserted dinosaur research center to a Red Wolf National Park, Park Ranger station. So that's going to be fun. I can just see the NPCs and the campers and all of the special gear. Oh, this is awesome. All right. So I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.